Have you ever wanted to learn how to collect and organize customer feedback inside of Softr? Well, lucky for you, we actually have a custom feedback template for customers that you can implement into your Softr workplace right now. This customer feedback template from Softr is a game changer. It enables you to gather valuable insights, handle feature requests, and streamline your communication with stakeholders all in a single organized portal. By actively seeking feedback, you not only improve your product, but also build trust and loyalty among your users. And lastly, you build a better connection with your users when you have it. If you go to softr.io/templates, you'll see this customer feedback template. And if we press preview, you'll see right here that this portal has the ability, if I press request feature, for anybody to fill out a form. Now, if I want to implement this into my own Softr workspace, I'm going to press use template. I'm going to connect it to my representative data source, connect it to my personal access token, and then copy it to my Airtable account. All right, so take a look right here. We have feedback submitted, features requests, and users. The users do have a couple different roles here, one being the product team and one being customer support. But you can see all the awesome forms that have been filled out and the feedback and feature requests submitted. Really simple and easy to do. Let's jump right into it. After I press create application, then this application is going to be connected to that new data that I created in my respective app. So now if I go to the users section, I'm going to check out some of these different magic links. As a product team member, you're able to see the feature requests by reporter type on this homepage. And this is a customer feedback dashboard that you have on your homepage. Now you'll notice here in the visibility side, this is only actually for non-logged in customers. This dashboard then would show for the customers that are logged in. So we can see what the feature requests by type are, what day of the week they were submitted, and you can actually edit this data inside of your Softr app. You can see here, it's based on feature requests in the Airtable data. It's a donut chart, and we can adjust the groupings. And you can see that it has tooltips enabled. So when I hover over it, extremely cool to check out how I can see the different amounts by clicking on it. I can even download this chart as well. Going back here, you'll see that by clicking on review feedback, that all those different submissions that were put inside of the original database here would showcase. And then I can press update to update the records to the different statuses. So open, reviewed, or archived. And these can all be filtered by their different ratings of the experience. If I only want to see open items for review, this one will pop up right here. And if I did want to search, I could search as well as amazing. And it'll showcase how it says amazing and fast resolution of bugs. On the back end, the review feedback page, you'll see that you can actually adjust what this searches by. If you go to the content section, you see that it's searching by all of these different columns here. And this can be adjusted, you know, say you wanted to type in the status for some reason. I know there's a filter, but totally up to you. You can adjust the row height right here. Very simple, cool, easy to do. Now also you have the ability to review feature requests right here in the features section. So if I click on this, it'll showcase the use case, priority, the date added, and a title and description. And then the status right here, whether it's prioritized, archived, all these different things, and the categories. These are all multiple filters to make this a much more reviewable experience. So for email marketing, it would be great to have an email marketing built in to manage with Softr. Totally fair. You can also update this feature request on the internal side. And then for request a feature, you yourself, even if you're on the team, can request a feature. And you'll see for logged in users, this is set to submit these inside of feature requests. There's a category dropdown and it's gonna map to the category. There's a feature name that'll map to that, a description as well, a use case section. You can map that to the use case section, a file that'll match to your attachments. And then you have two different things, request your email and requested by, and then the value would be team, since this is a team member that's submitting it. Whereas in the other case, for the visibility that's non-logged in users, you'll see that the value is going to be mapped to requested by as customer. So if we take a look at this and do request a feature, I'm going to request an analytics feature, new analytics dashboard. It'd be awesome to have a new analytics dashboard. The use case would be to see how we are doing with performance. Press submit a request. And then right here, in the feature requests, you'll see in the new analytics dashboard, river row, request or email, requested by team in this select property. Really, really awesome stuff. Able to pop up inside of here and the Softr app at the same time. And then moving forward inside of the app, we can actually go to quarterly planning and we'll see the planning out of these different things. And we can actually adjust these into different parts of this board view if we'd like, but this is lumped into the different categories right here. As you can see in the back end with OpenAI, this essentially just is for the categorization. And if we go back end here, with quarterly planning, these are just filtered to status is reviewed. So basically what different things have we decided to work on and are reviewed, that's what we're gonna end up going with here. Now this doesn't have to be like this, you can change this to a different status and have multiple views, totally up to you, but I really like that. Now on the other end, when it comes to customer support, they do have a more simple dashboard and a more simple view of everything. They're just able to see some less stuff. So here you'll see for what we had prior with the product team, they're able to see everything. Customer support is only gonna really be able to review feedback and then request a feature. They don't get an insight to the planning, all that kind of stuff, they just see the review. And then as we showed at the beginning, non-logged in users are going to see it as just this with the option to either give feedback with this nice form, which maps in a very similar way to the request feature. However, instead of going to this table, it'll go to this table. I'm a huge fan of this template. I think it's a really great way to get customer feedback. I don't think that there's any reason for why you would not try to do that. As a company, it's important on a daily basis to understand what your customers want and need. If you like this video, make sure to check out other videos like this one on how to improve your skills using Softr even more.